Hello friends, in today's class we are going to learn about named reaction and new named reaction in our YouTube channel, that is Staubach condensation reaction. And we will learn this reaction by, as we are learning, first we will see principle, then reaction, mechanism and application, all the parts, right? So let's start. What is the principle for Staubach reaction? The principle is condensation of diethyl succinate. Condensation of diethyl succinate and its derivative. First, you should know about succinic acid. If you know about the succinic acid, then only you can know about the succinate ester, right? So, butane-1,4-dioic acid. Butane-1,4-dioic acid is known as, that is known as succinic acid, right? If you take the ester, if you take the ester, okay, diethyl, you can put C2H5 over here. You can also put C2H5 over here. So that is known as diethyl succinate, right? And we can take the derivatives also. We can take the derivatives also. So the condensation of diethyl succinate and its derivative with carbonyl compound. See, carbonyl compound, either you can take in the form of aldehydes or you can take in the form of ketone, right? In presence of a base is known as Staubach condensation reaction. Staubach condensation reaction. So this is the basic principle. If you see, so this reaction is one type of application of the aldol condensation, right? So let's start. The reaction, you can take RCOR1. If you put one H here, it may be a formation of aldehyde. If you take both the carbon at R and R1, that will be ketone, right? And it will react with diethyl succinate, right? So in presence of potassium tertiary butoxide as a base, potassium tertiary butoxide as a base, right? If you react, you will get this type of product, which is one type of aldol condensation application part. So you will get an acid in this way. You will get an acid in this way. How this happening? Let's learn by the mechanism, right? So mechanism part, this is the diethyl succinate. Actually, there are two hydrogens. Actually, here one more hydrogen should be there. Right, but intentionally we wrote only one. Why? Because we want to take one proton, one hydrogen from the alpha position. As we learnt in aldol condensation previously, the alpha hydrogen will be taken by the base by donating the electron. So H will go with this base, right? That is tertiary butoxide base. Right, so it will take the proton and minus tertiary butanol will be there, and a negative charge formation will be here. That may tautomerize into enolate formation. This way, right? This is the enolate formation. As you know, in plus all, so that is in enol, right? And you can see the bond will shift here. How this bond can move here? The negative charge will be attracted by the partial positive charge on the carbonyl. See, as we seen in the reaction, just I'm going back, you can see a ketone, we took a ketone, right? So we are now reacting the succinate anion with the ketone. So as you know, electron here will attack on the positive, delta positive always happen in the carbonyl, and delta negative always happen in the oxygen due to the polarity and difference in the electronegativity, right? So oxygen may have negative charge, this carbon may have positive charge, will take the electron from here, right? And aldol condensation, aldol addition will be there. So after that, you can see what happened. You can see here the carbon connected to this carbon, see, I'm denoting by here, red color. This carbon connected to this carbon, right? So what will happen? Yeah, now we can see, just see. This carbon, This carbon of carbonyl is here connected to this carbon, as we seen, right? The writing style is only different, rest of the structure is same. And as we seen earlier, the negative charge formation is here, right? So by the negative charge, electron will not be stable, so it will donate electrons somewhere. So what, where to donate? Where some positive charge is there. So in the nearby region, one carbonyl of ester is here. One carbonyl's carbon is here, which may possess delta positive, and this oxygen may have delta negative charge. So definitely the electron will be donated to the positive charge, and formation of a lepton ring will be there, right? So O, it is already there. O minus generated by the carbonyl and oxygen connected with a covalent bond to the carbon by sharing of the electron. So this is called lectonization process. Rest of the part we are not touching. It is as it is, right? Now we are moving to the next step. What is going to be happen? The electron on oxygen are not stable due to the negative charge. So here the oxygen will take the electron. Oxygen will take the electron, and one ethoxide ion will be removed from the electron ring. So partial positive charge will be definitely generated. Why? Because the electron is donated to the oxygen. So oxygen may have negative, this may have positive. Now this electron will donate it to the positive, and formation of a new covalent bond, formation of a new carbonyl formation will be there, right? So that carbonyl formation you can see in the next. Yeah, you can see the carbonyl is here, and O, it is removed from this position, right? So we have this structure now. Again, we are taking a one new tertiary butoxide base, which will attack on the hydrogen by the electron, on the hydrogen. So it will donate electron to the hydrogen. So hydrogen may have now more electrons. So hydrogen will donate this electron to this carbon. Right, so hydrogen may have positive charge, will be neutralized by the electron getting from the base. So tertiary butanol will be again removed. Now this may have negative charge, this may have negative charge. This carbon donates its electron to the oxygen. So this carbon may have positive charge, this carbon may have positive charge, right? So now I am taking another color, that is blue color. So you can see a bond formation, double bond formation will be here between positive and negative charge, and this oxygen will get negative charge. So you can see the negative charge which we put it here is here, right? And this OCO that is here, now CH2 that is here, now connected to COOH that is here, but now the hydrogen is removed and formation of a new bond that is here, right? So it's very simple. You can see how this converted into this one. So ring chain compound convert into open chain. So ring opening, this is called ring opening part, right? Now by addition of H plus, you can make a COOH over here. In presence of H plus, now you may think from where H came. So we took the H outside from here, tertiary butanol that will be available. Again, tertiary butoxide will be there. So this H plus will convert into the product as we seen in the main reaction, right? So this is about the mechanism of Stoppe condensation reaction. It's very simple, and we are taking application of that. You can see the aldehyde is taken. Aldehyde is a carbonyl compound. You can draw the same aldehyde into this way. One H over here, and rest of the part, aromatic part, you can draw over here, right? So this is about the aldehyde, which is reacting in form of carbonyl. And this is your diethyl succinate. Definitely the reaction will get some product, but it gets cyclized, so converts into this way, right? So this is the one application. The second application, we are taking a derivative of diethyl succinate, as you can see, and it will react with the carbonyl. A double bond formation is here, and acid will be there, right? So this is the second application of the Stoppe condensation reaction. And this conditions, whatever you are reading here, don't worry about that. We just have to think about NaOH, which is a base, and rest of the condition. This reaction is taken from research paper, so condition is mentioned into that. Don't worry about that, but focus is our base catalyst, and ethanol is solvent, and we will get the product as we are learning in the Strobe condensation. So it is another application. Thank you very much for listening to me patiently. We will have a new name reaction in our next video. Keep learning. Subscribe my YouTube channel. Okay.